Welcome back to the channel. My name is NutRaisin. We are playing PLO 20 on RunItOnce.eu. Phil Galfond's poker site. And you know, maybe somebody is watching. Because Jay Nandis himself, of course, is streaming right now. So you know, I would completely understand if you'd rather watch that. I have until now. Right, we lost things to set up. Start off with a nice hand down here. Such a great flop. I'm gonna go for it though. If he checks behind, there's a decent chance I can take it down. I think. Maybe not. That might help. I'm not sure if I should fold now. Nah, didn't have it. He had the other thing. Oh well. So Jay Nandis is right now playing on the side as well. Unfortunately, so to say, there are enough PLO 50 tables going on to occupy his attention, so I doubt that I'll get a chance to play with him on PLO 20 just yet, just now. We'll see though. Oh, what's going on? I have to let it go. Right, and I played a little off-stream earlier. I finished up one buy-in while watching the Jay Nandis stream. King 7 deuce, I think I'll let it go. I raised so many of these hands, I don't necessarily need to raise this one, I think. Is, however, looks all right to me. Oof. What a flop. Gonna see it once and then be done with it. Because that doesn't need to work all that often in order to be profitable. See if we can get something going here. Ace check 10-5. Oh, take down the blinds, that's fine by me. Right, so overall in PLO 20, I'm still down a little, like 10 or 8 buy-ins since PLO 20 started, but worked my way up steadily yesterday, and you know, the one buy-in today also helped a little. And I feel the pool is pretty much the same as the PLO 20 pool. In fact, I think it is the PLO 10 pool. I think it is the same pool because, you know, nobody's playing PLO 10 anymore, everybody's on PLO 20. Case in point, zero players at PLO 10 right now, and everybody moved to PLO 20 with 32 entries, and this is nice. Getting to put more money in with the aces, let's... Double suited to boot, it's a queen and a four. Get a call, that is fine, that is a board. I've watched Phil Geffen and Jenna and there's no pressure. Yeah. Thanks for the good luck. Yeah, right, no pressure. So he just calls. The deuce, shouldn't really put him ahead if he's not yet. Yeah, me too, by the way, folks. In fact, I have been made a channel mod on the Jane Anders channel when I was watching earlier. This is a horrible card, naturally. One where we have to check up and give up on. Check and give up on, I mean. Don't need to check up on it. What do you know? It's a horrible card. Yeah. I do have a nice flop here. Go for the check raise. Ooh, nice splash. Can we do anything about it? I doubt it. Okay, that 8 is not great. We do have the 10, so let's go. And let's hit a set here. No, denied. 1, yeah, I can't really justify calling with the extra money. I took it down on table 2. Yeah, man, that Phil Gelfand session, did you see the call with the aces? It was like reasoning, the only thing he should have here is this and that, like kings that didn't connect to the straights, and he had exactly that. I mean, how crazy was that? So, we flop a very top pair, gutter and all that stuff. And take it down. Right, I reworked the emote and added two more. And they're getting improved right now, so I guess I doubt they'll make it in the stream tonight. But if you want, I can show them to you. After graphics stored, obviously. Actually, I'll just do that. You let me know what you think, folks. Or, you know, the rest of you, too. I still have the Jane Anders stream open on the side, just glancing over every once in a while to see if maybe he's stepping down to PLO 20. Yeah, you know, even with one person missing here, being five-handed, I'm not so sure this should be an open. Let's check it out. would be MP. Fairly certain it shouldn't be. I tell a lie. Is it an open under the gun, really? It's fine in MP and it can be a race call or race fold, so either one is fine. Still, the kinking 10-3 could be a race open race call. But the race call is more for balancing reasons, because all the other kinking 10s, like 10-4, 10-5, 10-6, all of these should be race folds. I think that one is in there for balancing reason and can thusly be ignored just to save on brain power. Because it's impossible to keep all of this stuff in mind. Okay, overpair, open-ender, against a very call-happy dude. He might do a toss again, maybe. He bets me with the fold. Doesn't do it, but that's obviously not a great river here. Right. So I got the pot button as an emote. Because you know that one seems fairly obvious. And I revoked the Shazam to make it hopefully more eligible. So it shouldn't have any background anymore. It should just be transparent now, the background. And because we love, I love the splashes, I figured, you know, something for the splash pots. Let me know what you think. Not much we can do right now on any table. I think one of the buttons is fine. Bought us position already, that's good. Don't mind if I take it down pre-flop. Never do. Needle. So, heads up, this has to be alright, right? Yeah, sure. Hang on, what am I thinking about? Ooh, the maces. Yeah, it was impressive. That was something else, man. He still has it, that is for sure. Right, it was a set of queens, that was what he had. And this is not a bad board, I would say. Yeah, and the chat went nuts too when that happened. And somebody from Runner once tweeted that, "No, it's he loves working there, but it's tough when your boss can read your mind." Ooh, only 25 entries at PLO 50. Maybe can share Jaina at this table. Gonna have to fold this as well. Yeah, and I fully expect this to be a very small, to stay a very small stream tonight, because everyone is, and you know, quite frankly, should be watching Jaina and us. But I felt like playing a little, and why the hell not? It's always fun to have some people keeping me company. Doesn't need to be in the dozens. We got a hand down here. And see a race in front of us. Happy times. More aces up here, I'll get back to those. And that is a board, I mean we do have that 7. I'm gonna check behind, I don't think. Oh, he's very short, never mind, then I could have just potted it. I was thinking about that's probably not gonna work out, and luckily for us it didn't. Here. Again, I do have a whole bunch of blocks, straight blockers, no flush blockers though. I think I'll check it, let's keep the pot small. That's it right away, and down here I honestly have no idea why the pot is so big. I think I must have misclicked and accidentally raised when I should have just called. I mean now, with the board pairing, I'm gonna go for it. And here I'm gonna let it go. It's not many turns where I'm happy to put in more money. Ooh, take that one down. I honestly have no idea what happened down there. Oops. I don't really want to play this out of position. I need to look this one up. Fairly positive it should be a fold. Never mind. Race fault. Race fault. Okay, no, it's perfect. And he bets really small. Let's see. I want to continue in this hand. For this price, yeah, let's take one off. Giving us an open ender. a happy spot for sure. I mean, not unexpected that he bet large, then after betting small, that's how it often goes. So for the stream, so far I think we're almost breaking even, maybe down a little, yeah, down half a buy-in, still up half a buy-in for the day, having played off stream a little. King Jack 5, 6, 1 off the button, I think it could go either way. Top and bottom, certainly a thing. Go for it. Just potting there is probably not horrible either. That's what I'll do now. Not blocking any of the flushes. Take it down. Yeah, I have a gutter and a flush draw. And I think I can take it away often enough here to bet. It's not like I'm betting with a zero equity against most hands. Curious to see if the icons are going to be approved today or if it takes until tomorrow. I think last time it needed like 12 hours. I think it was on a Sunday too, which surprised me that they approved them on a Sunday. Nice checking. Dudes. Take a little go and take this one instead. Yes, King Jack 8, double suited, looks much nicer. Here as well. And this board, I think I'm gonna check it. It did have the top pair, so you're kind of spaced out there for a moment. Didn't quite notice the top pair. Who knows, we might be good. No, low straight, huh? Yeah, me too. Susie the track, as random chiller would be saying. Right, so what are we gonna do here? Check. Okay. So I'm definitely not folding now. Leading out has a certain appeal as well, but I think checking, having him potentially bluff here, is a little bit more interesting. Or just try to value bet like a worse hand, like an ace-8, ace-5. Yeah, and I'm never folding. I mean, if I'm not even gonna think about it, if bet's pot, then bet's small. Question, should I raise? No is the answer here. And he had exactly that. An ace with a two pair, actually three pair, but that didn't really make any difference. What does make a difference is having the ace is pretty quite nice. Okay, well, we do have that flush. Let's turn an ace too, you know, make it lively. Just gonna check it down, I think. A straight could call me, sure. Straight could also bet now. And I think I'm leaning towards calling here. Yeah, a bunch of straights came in. Toby doesn't have like a like tens. Yeah, that's the other one that makes a lot of sense. And this is unfortunate, of course, but really see me folding there. I would have to put him on 10 specifically. Just maybe a little bit higher flush, but mine was 4 high. I guess like a 7, 8 high flush or any other flush might play it like exactly like that. But yeah, I don't mind how that went. With the 9, I'm gonna put this on the bigger end, I think. And that worked, thank you. Ooh, sorry, I had the wrong table and focus there. Won a small pot here, like a 3-4 euro pot. Sorry for that, I kind of spaced out. It is a Sunday after all, it's a quiet day. I think I'm gonna lead this. I don't really. I mean, check raising is an option, sure. Right, so here, raise call, he checked. I'm gonna bet, and I'm gonna bet the river again. Checking is also. Maybe check raising could be fun too. Actually, yeah, I think I would have liked that best. One for the check raise there. Rivering the flush. Again, very likely not folding here. Let's hope. Yeah. Get raised here, that's not horrible with that hand. The queen jack 10-8. No, jack. King queen jack 8. I don't know what's going on today. Definitely an very interesting board. I mean, if he puts it all in. Coming over the top is an option too. I mean, now I'm not folding. We're definitely getting the price, you know, even against aces here. So let's put it in. Felt nice. Shazam! Don't have the emote for that right now. It is being refurbished. If he comes over the top as a shorty, then you know we're gonna go with it. Right, they added a poll to the Twitch page, so if you scroll down a little, when you're not in full screen, and basically asking what you prefer, like four table view, more of the four table view, or just keep it zoomed into a table all the time. or as much as makes sense. So we do have that Ace of Spades, which is definitely helpful, especially when the pots are smaller. Okay. Now it'll have to put some work in, that Ace of Spades. Which by no means is, you know, it's not always effective. I think just calling is the way. Ooh, only 14 entries at PLO 50. Now we actually might have a shot at the Jane Nandis table. Gonna glance over there, we get the fold here, which is awesome. Yeah, 9 entries at PLO 50. I guess word got around that Jane Nandis is destroying the tables. I'm sure he is. Get raised here, really. You have the 9, 7, 7, 8, so 2 to 9. Okay, let's go then. Nice. You chose Tico! We'll keep grinding with you in the background, Mr. Runrun's PLO wizard. Those are very kind words. Thanks for stopping, for dropping in, man. That's very nice. You're gonna raise it up right away, I think. And good luck in your grind. And it looks like... They're only, so Jane Nandis is of course, this is a horrible turn. Is of course playing on runs right now, sitting at higher stakes and sitting at PLO 50. There's only 8 entries at PLO 50 now. So maybe we get to play with him. Keep glancing over to see if he's joining a PLO 20 table. And here we're just gonna check it. I hope to take it down. Yep. You know what? I think I'm gonna ditch this one. Yeah, I raised. I didn't raise with a combo draw here. I didn't have a jack in there as well. You know, full house with my exact hand. And aces. You know what? Actually, it's blind versus blind. Then maybe not that. Really? Now the king as well. This just keeps getting better and better. Oh, that's just nasty. I mean, it wouldn't make too much sense for him to have kings. Is the other thing here. Could have king jack. That's definitely the other thing. And I'm gonna let it go in a moment. And you know, I think the turn call here is a very interesting spot. And now the king is saving us the rest of our stack. That was just nasty. We do get a splash here. And I think I am gonna call this. It's a decent hand, all in all. And with all this money in there, I kinda like it. We have a spot up here as well for high raised. He raised, and you know, now this is all happening here. Yeah, I'm gonna call here. Unfortunately, no dice on table two. And this isn't great either. Did I take this one down? No, I didn't. No, no, no. Right, 5 entries at PLO 50. I've never been happier to see a small PLO 50 pool. I don't see any PLO 20 tables glancing over, not yet. But keep an eye on it. Okay, what's going on here? In the splash, very tight. Being as deep as we are, and wow. Open in a straight flush, top pair, blockers to the nuts. I think I'm... leading this, and I do take it down. Just checking here, sounds good to me. Interesting turn. Actually, it is a very interesting turn, seeing how many jacks we hold. That's a flush draw, and yeah. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for this one. Definitely played kings like that, sevens like that, king 10. Makes a lot of sense. Okay, he could have, of course, done the same. So, hold here, we have some other interesting spots on the rainbow board. It seems quite strong. Back in a sec. See, that's the Snesna. Well, isn't that great timing? You get raided by Jay Nandis and you have your mic muted. Oh lordy lord, thanks everybody for coming over. My name is NutRaisin. I play PLO 20 on this channel every day, so I can't entertain you on as high a level as Jay Nandis certainly can. But you know, I'll do my best, and thanks everybody for coming over with the raid. This is quite embarrassing to have my mic muted. I'm so proud of myself, you know, it's the third time I'm getting raided by Jay Nandis, which is awesome. And then yeah, I was very proud of myself of being a little bit more relaxed, having everything under control. A little more or less with, you know, so many people coming over. Then I have my mic muted! Isn't that just fitting? Right? Don't really need to play it suited to the jack, I guess, sandwiched. Yeah. And yeah, awesome. Well, I did that well. In any case, thanks very much for the host, Jay Nandis. Thanks a lot for everybody coming over. That is quite a thing to happen on a lazy Sunday. And yeah, now the stream suddenly got much bigger. Oh lord. Right, so I watched the Jay Nandis stream myself for quite a while there. Ooh, watching this for sure as well. The Ace Ace 10-4 double suited, wow. That is quite nice. And it is very kind that some of you have decided to follow me even when you didn't hear me talk. Maybe, you know, that's of benefit. Maybe that's what's holding me back, my own talking. It certainly has at certain points in my life. Not holding back here on this table, however, when Elton is nice enough to raise it up for us. And it's not horrible. We have the 10 as a blocker, we have the backdoor flush. Maybe a backdoor straight there a little bit. Embarrassing. With the mic, oh well. Moving on. Right, so how did the Jay Nandis session end? I kept glancing over and I noticed that he in the end finished up on the purple shirt on Blake. And yeah, I'm curious. No mic problems, just stupid. Just me being stupid. Yeah, man, don't.
I feel bad enough with the mic mute. That was so... such a bad timing. And you know, I wanted to get up and wash, get my lucky hat. How can I win without the lucky hat? And this might help though, being able to squeeze here with a very nice looking ace king jack 9 double suited. How neat is that? I know, right? 200 viewers? Jesus. Headphone user destroyed. I gotta need to get myself a new mic. Woot! Thanks a lot, Late Drake, Kitschy Glossart, and Fold in the Dark for the follows. And on one hand, we do have to not flush, but there's a whole bunch of full houses out there now. It's quite iffy. And okay, checking it down seems fine by me. Silent movie style, yeah. I should be moving a little bit faster then, right? Like, you know, usually when you watch the old silent movies, they're sped up a little bit. And things are going quite well, Arrestor. Thank you for asking. Now, with so many people watching, they're going. The day suddenly got really exciting. Calling is fine. Yeah, but it was supposed to be a lazy Sunday afternoon stream. Suddenly isn't as lazy anymore. It certainly hyped me up. And you know, amongst all the... what's going on? Those aggressive raises are close in the action. We are deep against this dude, so yeah, sure. Woo! We're in position too. Sleazy MF! I tried with all the caches. You know, the caches that Jay Nantis left on the tables. And good luck at the casino, mate. But the question is, the fan, what shirt did you get? I got the gray shirt, which is the understatement in fashion ever that I've ever seen when it comes to representing a brand that has... I'm not wearing it right now, I wore it yesterday. It has like one small logo on the sleeve here, and that's all that lets you tell that it's a Run at Once shirt. And how beautiful is that spot, I mean... Okay, definitely has a hand. Will he get there? No, sorry, he will not. And Shazam! I should play higher? You know what? I can't! Because being a paranoid German, I locked myself out of playing higher than 25. Not because I ever had any problems with, you know, chasing my losses or anything like that. Just because in the back of my mind, I was thinking, you know, if I get hacked, they really have to work to chip dump. Not sure how valid of an approach that is, but, you know, you try talking sense into a paranoid person. Not that I really am. Well, even though everybody keeps telling me I am. What? Yeah, one PLO 50 table. It would be the proper way to celebrate all of you sticking around. But yeah, I cannot due to technical reasons. Right, so that was certainly a happy occasion up there on table 2. And off to a good start. Okay, now I think the consensus seems to be so far. I added a poll underneath the channel, like in the Twitch page, if people would prefer to have one table zoomed in the whole time or go back to the four table view whenever there's nothing interesting happening on one table. And you know, if you have an opinion about it, by all means tell me. I haven't been twitching for that long. I'm eager for any input I can get. Right, let's do it. Double suited ace 995. Why not? And we flop interesting. What is not as awesome is that the whole table decided to be in here as well. We do have like all the blockers, right? Hang on. First of all, we have the second nuts here. This is a rainbow board. I think betting isn't completely horrible. Trap City! Wait, what's happening? Oh, wait, I have the full house. I was like, ooh, you had nothing. Get called here, and that's interesting. So, Shazam on table 4 as well. Shazam! And here, I mean, one thing, we do block the 8 by proxy a little bit, you know. A lot of hands that have 8s in them have a 9 or have a 9 in them as well, so not sure how useful this is in this case. I guess just pawning it, representing the aces here. Okay, now I'm fine checking it down. I have plenty of showdown value. There could be full houses out there for sure. Hate to get raised a bit small or something like that. I'll just check it. I think I'm gonna be good quite often. Lordy lord. Ace-8, okay, I was ready to cheer there. I saw just the 8, I didn't notice the ace, and yeah, we do get a consolation prize over here after making a very questionable call. Getting the ace-ace, king-king, double-suited, how much better does it get? Yoink the host? This never happened. I have a mic on the whole time, I was just speaking very low. Oh, that's the shirt you got. Let me. Ooh, that is a nice one with the logo. Yeah, that's also a subtle logo. I dig it. Ooh, talking about digging things. The digging doesn't stop. On table 2, one table guy. You say that is very helpful feedback. Let's do it. Play for it all. My pleasure, line hippie. What you gonna do? No king. No, that's perfect. Wow, we're sitting on a stack on table 2. I still feel stupid about the call on table 1, but you know, that kind of alleviates the pain a little bit. And what a timing to not being able to show off my own emotes, because they're, worked them over a little bit. It sounds like I beat them up. You worked the guy over. Get this money. And yeah, they need to be approved, so I can't join the emote game. At least not with original content. So what am I gonna do down here? I think even against the sleepy dude coming over the top sounds kind of okay. A mix of both, you say, sleazy? Yeah, okay. That's should be a third option, the pole. Okay. Top pair. Sounds reasonable to me. How does it sound to you, Ted? Huh. Ted it is. Ooh, neato. Neato. And yeah, I'm quite happy to be winning some hands. I've made only one stupid call so far in front of so many people. Reasonably good stuff. Down here. Hate calling the small blind. I think it should be a fold. Let's look it up. Was it ace 10, 8, 7, I believe? Ace 10, 8, 7, yep. He was MP, I'm fairly certain it should be a fold. Actually, one of the spots where just calling is fine, like pretty much the only hand with the ace 10 that can be called. Interesting, but it's no big deal either way. I suspect it's in there for balancing reasons, maybe? The dream, right? I mean, I get raided and then, except for the mic thing, which never happened, I do run well right now. And speaking about running well, certainly a source of joy down here. I'm gonna raise it too big, I think. Yeah, I don't think he can really call with his stack size. He's either all in or fold. We're not blocking like a ace, queen, 10 here. Took it down. Seeing as we're at queen, 10, 9, 8 on the button versus the ever entertaining open limp in the cutoff. Never ceases to be funny. Woo! Of a real hat. I need to, man. Have you seen my hairline? It's more face to wash, less hair to comb with every passing month. Oh, I was gonna say I'm not gonna raise this one because I see a lot of folds, but we are three-way. Good thing I noticed. Yeah, still. Still everybody decided to fold, so stabby on straight boards. The one and only. Hey, Bald and Handsome. Thanks for the good luck. Yeah, I have a tough time stopping smiling. The third raid. This channel is, you know, 8 weeks old. This is all kinds of amazing. I am closing the action. Crazy, or at least lose aggressive. Sure. You're a lot more popular than the other day. It's the hat, I tell you. It is the hat. Also, I switched voodoo priests. And the new one is apparently doing it for me. Viewbot is a hell of a drug. Ooh, taking notes right there. I actually heard about it yesterday, about that's a thing, but I don't think that's the way to go with the runner once promotion. This is a sucky turn.
for all sorts of reasons. This bet size. I can boat up, I can make the straight. Maybe it goes check, check. Whew. Neato. And I hope this guy knows what he's doing, and if he has the same hand, he doesn't raise, because all we end up doing in that case would be to pay more rake. Fold. That is the other good option. Thanks. Thanks, Glory Man. It is quite a thrill. I'm gonna let this go. I suck at heads up and I tend to avoid it whenever I can. No idea what hands should be played. Here, this one I'm gonna let go. Are you finding TwitchNet? Right, the thing you got me into, like the Discord thing. It is pretty neat. I like put down my bio on their page, and in the Discord apparently they put you in the streaming section automatically whenever you know you stream. Let me check up on that. And you know, can only help to grow the channel. Ooh, interesting stuff. In case you know Poker Bakes. A very, very relaxed dude who is just a high level. Okay, let's get in here. High level tournaments. Hang on. Tournament player online, and anyway, so another dude, called the Golden Blazer, has a promotion where he ran like the most top 64 streamers sorted by viewers, which apparently I was in there, like, okay. And so like right, and so all he put all these streamers in a bracket, and everyone is now can either have a Twitch vote or like play a heads up match. To see who moves up in the brackets, and I don't know what the final thing is gonna be. Actually, I forgot to ask them about that yesterday. Now, is there any sense in calling here? I really want to, but on a paired board, I mean, how much joy will I find? Even on a good turn there. Yeah, I decided to come over the top, because why not? Right, and so long story short, that I wrote this PokerBakes dude that we are now in round two, facing each other in the bracket, and if he wants to play, and he said yes, and that is a long story short. Most of my stories could be shorter, they usually are not. That's like a hallmark of this channel, me talking. Unless my microphone is muted, of course. Worth a shot here, trying to take it down. We do have an open ender now. Actually, we have two pairs as well. We do have some full house outs. Yeah. That is certainly within your rights, Isaiah. To bet the pot there. It's not a happy thing to do, but I'm sure you like it. Ooh, talking about, you know, things and liking them. Maybe I have like a crazy image. Now after the last hand, maybe that'll help. Cold call, really. Okay. That'll do. That'll do. Over here, I'm just gonna check behind, I think. Yeah. No reason to do anything, but even three ways, I feel that's the way to go. Shouldn't be that many fives out there. Taking it down, it was a nice pot. And then 50 BB pot. Head Ace is over here. They get the job done.
Unknown grinder. You know, I didn't get those. All these people are not here because of my own merits. They're here because Jane Anders was so kind and brought them over. But hey, welcome back to the channel, Unknown.
And Unknown Grinder, of course, is a no limit streamer stemming from Russia, doing a very fine job in the streams and playing No Limit 4 right now on Rendered Ones. So, you know, if you like to see the two card Omaha every once in a while, consider checking out his channel. And while I'm at that, you know, the fan is in the chat here as well, and he plays very high stakes and No Limit does that very well from my, you know, from what I understand about No Limit, which isn't a lot. So what's going on here? You checked, I'm out of position, I could have played a hand that can value bet now, so like this, certainly. Hoping to get the check raise in. You have the ace blocking that the straight a little. You know, queens, jacks have a fairly tough time now. In my mind, 10s, 9-5s, so it's even closing the action with the 5 in there. I'm gonna let it go. That 10 and a 5 is never a happy combination.
Thanks a lot, NM1212. I appreciate hearing that.
Yeah, that's how this stream is usually going down. Me talking around, making some good moves, certainly making enough bad moves along the way as well, and talking a lot. Usually about the hands.
The hands at hand.
And ever since Rendered Ones opened, I used to be a short stacker on microgaming, and ever since Rendered Ones opened, I moved all my volume over, decided to make my way through the micros yet again, playing 100 BB poker, and you know, deep stacked. And that's what I've been doing every day ever since, hardly taking a day off.
Loriman, I'll do that! She actually was kind enough, she's one of the founders of TwitchNet, right? Or Twitch, what was it? TwitchNet.
And she was kind enough to answer some questions I had yesterday. And I certainly ask her about it. At this point, I also always have to mention that MPAdam66, who is a mod for XValdhaus, has been exceptionally kind to me already and took a lot of time out of his certainly busy days to help me out already. But that's not to say that I've gotten all the advice that I needed, and I'll certainly ask Sidegasm about, you know, stuff. And thanks. Thanks. Just gonna check it again here. I think he bets a lot when check too. We had this happening a bunch of times. But I think it doesn't really make sense to raise after I checked behind, so I'm gonna take a mental note on this dude, but leave it for now. Now this really shouldn't be a board for the small blind all that often, right? So I don't have a diamond, but I think betting and betting quite big on any non-diamond turn that, you know, is not an ace or a king has some merit here, and he agreed. I like it.
I did, right? I did get it.
It's like I was talking to the chat on the Jane Anders channel, and then I saw Oresto shooting me a message on Discord, and I was like, oh, I bet he's telling me off because I've been talking too much, cluttering up the stream, the chat.
And no, quite the opposite. He was like, he said I should keep cluttering and, you know, wanted to ask me to be a mod. That was quite the thing to happen. NM, 1212, thanks a lot for the follow. So we flop quite happy here, I think. And, you know, we pre-flop quite happy here. And this one, I think I'll let go for this bet size. It's not that many turns that I'm gonna really dig. And yeah, now I have the sword on the Jane Anders channel. And get to talk. As much as I had been already. And thanks for the kind words there. I mean, who knows, maybe. Fine in the cutoff. So let's take the tally here. Let's see how the session has been going so far. And this has been going well. We are up almost three buy-ins, I think, in the session and in total four-ish. You know, poker players and basic math, usually not a good combination. Sure thing. Okay. Giving us the wrap, backdoor flush if need be. He checks, and even without a pair, I think this is fine to bet here. And we end up taking it down. Looks like here we're gonna be closing the action, and you know, in that case I think it's okay to call. Certainly can flop stuff. Let's see if we do. I think that qualifies as stuff. Stuff confirmed. Not really looking to get raised though. It's gonna be really tough to make a full house having a pair in my hand. Here I came out of top, button versus small blinds spot. With the 10 blocker, I think I'm gonna go for it. Have the backdoor flush as well. So, the king, I'm not sure how I feel about the king. So it took it down on table 1, by the way, with the c-bet there. Right, still not looking to get re-raised here. I'm gonna do it again to this dude. Okay, he's talking about doing things and doing them to people. He's doing it to me, and I'm gonna let it go in a moment. And here, this is pretty awesome, all in all. I raised a call 3-bet. I flop a 2-pair backdoor flush. Table 4, I'm gonna let it go. He takes it down, he goes all in, as he should. His hearts does not get there. Does not get there. Shazam! I came on top here as well for, you know, I think all the right reasons, but not quite a happy flop this time. Which is fair, you know. We don't need to win them all. Talking about winning stuff. This looks good. End up making 2-pair. I highly doubt they're gonna be good. Right, so he calls, don't mind that. Interesting one, I really doubt he has kings here. I mean, like kings on an open end are sure that I see. He bets, and then, you know, if that's not a straight, then I'll eat like someone's head. Not necessarily mine, or low flush. What's the move here? Thanks, Gloryman. Those are nice words. He does call, and let's hope he doesn't have kings with the open. He did have not even the open ender, just a jack and the kings there. Wow. Sergeant Pepper, welcome back to the channel, Sergeant. And the evening is great. I get to share it with so many of you. So what happened there? He had the king jack seven, so he flopped a pair. He had the over pair. Called there twice. He did have hearts on the turn, so I guess that kind of that makes sense. The turn call when the heart turned, he turned a flush draw. Yeah, can't really read too much into that. I think that made sense. Calling the flop, sure. For one bet there, and then turn the flush draw. Yeah. But I knew the deuce wasn't a good river there. I had a feeling. Unknown grinder. I'll do my best, you know, that's what I do on this channel. I talk what I understand about these spots, and I talk quite a lot about them. It's not certainly, not necessarily the correct advice. Like always, but you know, I... At least you get a look into the mindset of a aspiring microstakes grinder, and that's certainly helpful. Also helpful is this, I think, very much so. This is less so. I could have just let there, actually. Making the nuts in the end is fine. Certainly are gonna be the nuts. Unless he rivered like sevens. Today's good for PLO, or to you and your next bracket competitor. Oh, Poker Bakes is alive as well, isn't he? Isn't he? I didn't know he played cash. Assuming you mean you're saying he's playing a tournament? And you know, if I'm gonna do a heads-up tournament against him for the bracket, then I'm properly frightened, man. That dude is a beast. I've seen him made like casual moves that kept blowing my mind on in the tournaments he was playing. Like, it looked casual, but they looked very high level. Like there was very high level thinking behind them, from what I understand about no limit tournaments, which is not a lot. Except that apparently, if you have it, you don't think and you shove the chips in, as seen by Phil Hellmuth, like that. You know, the quantum shove, where basically no time passes between the chip sitting in front of him and being in the middle. Right. Okay, the Ace of Diamonds might have to put a lot of work in here at some point. Yeah, and you know, Unknown Grinder, I'll always help. I'm always happy to help in any capacity I can. With the PLO. The nines, certainly there's King Nines out there, or even some Six Nines, but we do have the King locking that a little bit. So nobody's showing interest in this. I do have the 7, but I mean, heck, let's do it. Heck, let's do it. South Beach for 20. Thanks a lot for the follow. It's nice, Gloryman, the preflop trainer. And Marcitko, also, thanks a lot for the follow. Certainly one more reason to smile. Maybe take it down with the 7 here. Come on, Danny. Should have made your mind up by now already. Yeah, the preflop trainer is very nice. I used it when reviewing hands that I come. No, really? Didn't need to do that. 5-4. Ah, Lord. Oh, good for you. Nah, it's fine. And yeah, at runtime I used the Matrix. A few, he says. A nice hand, I say. Just because it's easier to use. I'm not using it to figure out stuff while it's happening. I always wait until the preflop part is over. But preflop trainer, the Genesis trainer, certainly gives more information than the matrix, and I dig it for that a lot. Also digging flopping the set here, he never has aces. At least he really shouldn't. No, with his deck size, he really shouldn't. Colovins. The short answer is because... Why I bet there? The short answer is because I didn't finish my train of thought. I was on the right track in my mind, I believe. And had I thought about it longer, I would have ended up putting him on kings and just checking. Yeah, I don't really want to claim it was a blocker bet. It certainly worked this one in the end, but I don't want to claim that was what was going on in my mind there. Yeah, I didn't really... Yeah, that's the answer. I didn't really think it through. I mean, he never had aces. I was pretty certain about that. And kings, you know, there's not that many kings out there. But turns out enough of them were... Like two pair in the river is not a bad for you if you want to block better someone, not pay a higher price. Yeah, it makes a whole bunch of sense to me. Colorwinds, it sounds very good. Ooh, gonna let this go. Yeah, I like your take, and I think I would have arrived at a very similar conclusion in that case, given a little bit more time. On back in a second. I will not mute the mic this time. That's what happened to me last time. Who knows who's gonna raid me this time, so I'll leave it unmuted. Right, check mute, not muted. All is good in the world. Right. So. Down here, I think it's certainly worth a bet. And here, I think calling is fine. I do have the 10-9 in there, three Broadway cards. We flop stuff, I mean. Here we get called, and that is not a happy turn for sure. Here, I do like it. Here, I ended up checking, ready to give it up. Right. I think I let it go. And I'm checking here, let's see what happens. He has a 3, okay. Very conservative on the turn. I'll take a note of that in a moment. Yeah, he signaled that he... Hang on, no, I didn't... I need to check what happened there. Here, with the blocker, sure. Wait, here, sorry about that. Take it down. Let me first check out what happened on table 2. What he ended up holding, we didn't see, because... Ethan bet once more, the other dude folded. Fair enough. Interesting. Just trying to take a note down here, hang on. Right. Taking it down there, which is certainly nice. He's playing MTTs right now. Oh, fair enough, fair enough. Yeah, he, right. So he got back to me in Discord and asked me to, ask him again later, because, you know, now he's busy. He didn't say that, he just says, he said, basically, let's talk tonight, and then we'll figure something out. Fridgeman! That's a cool nick. So funny to me. Thanks for the follow. Right. Sure. Yeah, I mean, I think the max is 120 seconds time bank in the end. Like, after so and so many hands, it adds like 10 seconds up to 120 in total. So it's not like I was really running out of time, I just didn't take the time. But I think it's fine, the time bank, for me, with the streaming and the talking and, you know, divided attention every once in a while. Especially in the beginning, in the first weeks of streaming, I did time out a bunch of times. Now that really doesn't happen too much anymore. But another 10 seconds, yeah, wouldn't go amiss. Yeah, so we will definitely do some sort of heads up there, Sergeant Pepper. I'm very much looking forward to it, and I mean I really dig a stream. I host him whenever I can. It's just a great, amazing vibe on his channel. Talking about amazing. That is quite nice. The open-ended straight flush draw. Most of a wrap going on there. He's not falling. We need to get there. And, you know, they're getting there. Has got there. So I guess like two pair. Ace 9, maybe a river to ace king, ace queen. Let's check it out. Ace 8, yeah, same difference. Ace king, 8 deuce. Triple suited to the ace and hearts. Any hearts there? Nope. What do you flop two pair, and you know, that's all reasonable. So it's coming over the top here, I think. And queen 10, 9, 7, sure. It's the short stick who should be really tight, by the way. Well, not really, he's at 50 BB, so it's not like he has to tighten up immensely. Take it down there on table 2 with the preflop. 3-bet. No spades, the gutter. A bunch of straight blockers. Business. Okay. Business has been gotten, huh? With top two, wow. Didn't misread that, right? No, we didn't split it. Neat! Shazam! Let me just double check. I didn't misread anything, but I don't think we split this one. You know, there's certainly gonna be fixed in the next big patch that is on its way with short all-in animations and even the pot seemingly being pushed in the wrong direction in multi-way pots sometimes. Just calling is fine. Not gonna resort to calling here. No reason with the ace 8 6 double almost double suited. The other kind of double suited. The one where it's only single suited. Okay. Of all the turns, this is not a horrible one. At all. Yeah, I think the hand is good enough to bet. Not sure what I should be wrapping in their mind, like a turn set of tens, I guess. Yeah, he just calls. I mean, I do block the straight draws between, like, the wrap between the 6 and the 10. Not the other one, though. Blocking the nut flush. See what comes of it. I think he was quite call happy at an earlier hand. Ooh, not this time. Nice. And good stuff keeps happening, you know. Certainly some action going on here. Good timing. Fritwin, welcome to the channel, and thanks a whole bunch for the follow. We are not invited to this party. I think that I shall not crash it either. Let's let them have a little fun. Tipperi, Jane Andes. The third Jane Andes raid in the history of this channel. And I, you know, screwed it up, had my mic muted for the first, like, 4 minutes. Which is, you know, how the pros do it. Like, keep them guessing, keep them waiting. Oh, it was quite embarrassing. Yeah, Jane Andes came and brought 500 friends over. Right, so with the Ace of Hearts, I think I prefer starting to bet now. So I can certainly continue betting on any heart card turning there. Here, I do have the 9, I have both of the back doors. Curious to see if he bets again. Right, unfortunately table 2 where I'm sitting at with a really deep stack is breaking. Only 3 people now, and I suck at shorthand, so I'm gonna leave this one at the next big blind. He decides he really likes this board, and who am I to argue? 59 entries at PLO 20 right now. Certainly very nice. Especially for a Sunday evening, where the numbers are usually a little bit lower right now than on the during the week. Oh, and also, hi Kipperi. I completely forgot among all the excitement. Yeah, so he's always gonna bet here. Like, he did this a whole bunch of times. The hat! I got the hat from the official source. They asked me if I would like to
receive a swag package, you know, and somebody offers you swag, can't really say no, specifically because swag is such an awesome word, so very piratey.
Yeah, and offered it did. Sent me a t-shirt, some playing cards. And you know, Germans blew my mind with being German. I had to pick it up at the customs office, cause... why ever. And the dude knew the tax for playing cards coming from foreign countries. Like, oh, what the hell is that? I was like, I think you've been to this job too long, mate. How do you know that? How do you want to know that? How often does do playing cards get shipped over? But doesn't matter. Still, kind of blew my mind a little. Wait. Oh, the table had filled up and I really didn't want to leave it. Actually, I had already closed the other table. Forgot to check the option though.
LB. Welcome back, LB. And I can't compete in the emote game because I redid my emotes and resent them to Twitch and I need to get approved. Is Queen 8 deuce? I think I'm gonna... well, there's some extra money in there. Okay, fair enough, my friend.
So how's the day been going? Pretty well. Pretty well. In total for the day, up 5 buy-ins. YOLO? YOLO indeed, Jesus Christ, so... he gets the note, Splashpot Maniac. STPM is the new abbreviation. And, you know, if you play on Run It Once, you'll need this one surprisingly often. Christian, right, there are no huts on Run It Once. What you do have, and I was concerned about that, I really was, being a hut player all my life. You know, how do you keep track of the table dynamics? But what they did was they have the dynamic avatars. And so at a glance you can see that I'm sleeping in all the tables, coincidentally. Which I feel isn't justified, I played a bunch of hands. Anyway, so you have the dynamic avatars, like this dude is loose aggressive, this dude is very tight, this dude tight aggressive, and so... while you don't get the exact stats, like, you know, VP 19, whatever, it does allow me to get a decent feel for the table dynamic, and I was surprised myself that I don't mind using a HUD, not using a HUD anymore. Also, it's kind of liberating. In the sense that you're not glued to those stats, you just get a more general feel for what's going on the table. If that makes sense. And you know, I'm not saying that because I'm streaming for Run It Once. I'm streaming for Run It Once because I found these things to be true. Same with the splash pots, where I was very much on the fence about them in the beginning. But now with all the action I bring, and you know, things that keep happening, case in point here, the splashbuck maniac there, in the last hand. I dig it. I dig the action they bring. Another splash pot with the deuce. I'm not gonna be in there. That's kind of tempting. Would have been tough, but would have, could have, should have is never a thing on this channel. Right. I had no idea what the move is here. I know calling into small blind is generally frowned upon.
certainly gonna seabed pretty much always once I come over the top. And now at this point I'm happily giving up. Woot! Trentosk, thanks for the follow, mate. And Trentosk, a fellow PLO 50 streamer and chess player. Chess player. Wait, did I end up wearing it here? That poor guy. And speaking about poor guys, this is certainly good for us up here. I need to, take a second look at that one. See if he buys it as a bluff. Took it down on table 3. Interesting spot here. I think I'm gonna pot this. How in the heck did I end up on top here in this end? Okay, he folds and he comes over the top and that is okay. Woo! 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 Shazam! Color wins! How's the day go? Yeah, the day has been gone great. Raiding from afar, thanks for the good luck, thanks for the follow, my friend. And yeah, let's dig your streams as well. Yeah, I'll just get something to drink. Again, I shall not mute the mic. And now the secret is out. It was truly meant to be a lazy after Sunday night. I'm not even wearing proper pants. Just the old sweatpants. I was not prepared to have so many people seeing that. Right, and this is one of the few bugs that keep cropping up, where once you get auto sit out, you can't sit back in. No big deal, just rejoin the pool. I think going for the check raise here once more is the way to go. Top pair, blockers, gutter ourselves. Make that the nuts. Hey, bye, Anon Grinder, and thanks, I'll try my best. Go, I think. Who? What kind of misclick? I'm confused. Right, so with the recent pots, I mean, things certainly didn't get worse. Nope. 5-6 buy-ins, something like that. Yeah, 6. Needle.
Right, Omaha fun player. That's the only sad thing, well, you know, in air quotes, with PLO 20 being added, which I liked, that meant that PLO 10 right now is kind of dead. A lot of people were apparently waiting for PLO 20. So case in point right now, there's 58 entries at PLO 20 and only one at PLO 10, but what? I still don't completely gotten used to the idea that people subscribe. Thank you very much, Trentosk. Or Trento SK, whatever the... don't want to butcher the name. That's very nice of you. That's quite a thing to happen, thanks. And Equivero907, thanks a lot for the follow as well. The reasons to continue smiling, just don't stop. And right, so traffic, PLO traffic itself is doing well, very well for such a small site. They often beat microgaming. Yeah, just a caveat is this right now with PLO 20, you don't really have that much PLO 10 going on. On the other hand, I know people like Epic Tilter, friends of the channel, and other people are waiting for the... are playing PLO 10 as well, and you know, all we need is two more people on the site to play PLO 10, throw in their 6 entries, and then, you know, if I was to register PLO 10, close all these tables, and put my 6 entries in there, it would read 6, you know, and then all the other people that would look to play would be more likely to join, and it would snowball from, it will snowball from there. And other than that, the traffic, as I said, is nice, and the player pools, the tables are not nearly as rag-infested as I was afraid they would be before the site opened, because, you know, it's beta, they're not really advertising. Hang on, stuff is happening and it is awesome! Got that beautiful double-suited ace-ace jack-8 here. And here, I'm just gonna check behind. I do have the king blocker, but, you know, neato. Get called here, money's gone in. The gutter, the blockers, backdoor flush on a rainbow board. Not super ecstatic, but yeah. Please don't have a 9, sir. Ooh, please don't get a flush. Yes, yes, yes. That was a very decent pot right there. I hope I had the right table in focus. Right, so Brainy one. Wish you the best of luck, sir. Thank you very much. That is very much appreciated. And you know, I never sneeze at more luck. Can certainly use that. Especially with the holds that are certainly in my game here and there. And the Omaha fun player has decided to spread the fun and follow the channel. Thanks a lot. Okay. Let's do that, Trentosk. I'll certainly read it, and I'll do it as you say. I won't read it, you know, reply now. And, you know, have a very pleasant evening. And thanks for the good luck wishes. Speak to, we'll talk tomorrow, yeah. I don't think I'm gonna be falling. Pair outs, like most of them are pretty clean, as in they don't put a straight on there, the king or the ace. That is not a happy river. Yeah, don't have to fight for every pot. Yeah, my pleasure. Oh, what? Why? Why did we take that down? What's going on? Is it like a wrap? I misread my hand? No, I had a pair. Yeah, he had a wrap. He had a 7-6-4-3. That makes a lot of sense then. I think calling makes sense here as well. Kind of a relief not to flop a miracle board. So it was getting kind of scary there for a moment. And just when I said kind of scary, I immediately glanced over like, do I have a mic on? Oh. I think more checking is the way. Yeah, I read your question there, in case you're still here, Trentusk, and I can certainly help you with that tomorrow, how to zoom into the tables. Let's watch what happens in the split part here. Certainly a good day. All the tables and off. What with the raid and all. Ah, this one I'm gonna let go with the 5 and a deuce in there. Bad, double suited. Not sure, but I think it should be called, right? Check it out in a moment. Well, let's see. I mean, I think he's never folding when I go all in. Hope for like a 9 or jack. 7 is very nice as well. If he checks, so if you bet small, I'm certainly gonna come over the top now. I think that's my plan. I'm not saying it's a good plan, it's the one I got. And I think the plan for a pot size bet here is to fold. Yeah. This would have been a different story. This would have been the spot where I would have preferred to be out of position, actually. Okay, let's do that. We do flop a little bit of it. And here, this is certainly nice. We are blocking our own out, but no, it is what it is. Ended up calling here. See what happens now with the bet sizes. Should he bet YOLO, huh? Okay, let's YOLO it up then. He bets for full pot and I'm out. Still good. No heart, no heart. Oh, yeah! Everybody had hearts! Oh, well. Can't really complain. Nice hand, you say. Nice hand, I say. What was going on there? So we had, in the hand, we had Edward and, what's his nose? Greg. Closing the action, well, on the other hand. So we had Edward with the ace 10, 9, 4, hearts to the ace. So a gutter and a flush draw. And we had Greg with a crab, I believe. Oh, a bottom set and hearts. Yeah, that's tough. It's not a spot I envy him for. So we should have zoomed in there. Yeah, I'm just gonna fold. Take it down here without a call. That was a pretty sizable pot there, but We definitely got it in with the best of they each were blocking their own outs. It's unfortunate that he had a set blocking our full house and I was blocking the jack, further blocking the full house there. But still. Definitely not a bad spot. Oh, he had a royal. I'm just noticing he had a royal flush. Fair enough. It's like the second one I've seen in 2 weeks or something like that. Hang on, the cat wants to be let inside. Yo-yo. But we do have to gutter ourselves. Rainbow board. I'll take it. And you know, losing against the royal flush. Can't really be mad about that. Not mad about taking down this one. And the absence of madness continues. And I receive the ace-ace, jack-six on the button here. Completely offsuit, but still, aces. It's a decent board where we have the nut flush blocker. Might come in handy. Also the jack, the six, so are nice blockers. He decided to be sticky on the turn, and he just wait. Go for value, hopefully for value in a moment. And here I'm just gonna call. I'll drop the hammer on the any non-pairing river there. Try my best to make it look like a value bet there. Take it down on table one without being called. I see you saw it right away, Belly Beast. I didn't spot that one. Took it down here, certainly a nice thing. I mean, I'm gonna let it go and curse myself that I should have raised it once I look it up. But either way, it's not a big deal, I'm sure. Let's do look it up though. Splash button madness going on up here. No, okay. Was it 10-10 or jack-jack? Jack 10-10 for singer suited. No, it's fine. Cutoff is to 10-6. Well, it makes sense. That way you can still make straights. And blockers, top pair, backdoor nut flush. What happens over here? Might slow him down. I'll just let him go. I do block kings and aces a little, so maybe that would be a spot to bluff. Had he bet, I certainly would have entertained coming over the top here, and he took it down with like a ragged pocket pair or something, right? An 8-6-4, so he had a pair of sixes, okay, and a flush draw, so certainly in the wider end pre.
You know how to say that a watched pot never boils? A watched cat also never moves. Especially not when it's supposed to. And if it does, it moves in the wrong direction.
Ooh.
Nothing wrong about this. Cats.
Of course, as soon as you close the door, he moves back to it.
And this is quite nice.
Oh, Garfield.
Oh, Lord. I think I'm gonna let this go.
Ah, success.
Right on. Right, so in case you'd like to know right now, 53 entries below 20, 5 entries below 50. So what I usually see, and I'm, you know, playing every day, is that during the weekdays, right now, that's roughly the same number we have at PLO 20 usually, like 50, 60, sometimes even more. The number has been rising steadily in the last weeks. And like 30 to 50 at PLO 50. And all we need is a very few people to kickstart the PLO 10 games. I used to be one of them, but you know, with the introduction of PLO 20, I moved up.
Oh, that was you! That was Kippery there. So, down here, friend of the channel, well-known Finnish low-stakes professional and a long-time coach for poker strategy. He has a channel as well. By all means, check out Kippery.
As much as I like to talk, I'm certain he knows more. I'm positive he knows more about the stuff he's talking about.
So 50 and 4, 52 and 40, so the other dude had 8%.
Yeah, so that's the friend of the channel shirt, doesn't have any other meaning. Big splash here, let's try the old limp. Which is a fool's errand at PLO 10. At PLO 20 it seems to work relatively often, in that, you know, nobody comes over the top. At PLO 10, people just go nuts. Which is why I ended up liking the splashes so much. You know, I've seen all-ins where... Let's watch. Can I be in here? Multiway? I kinda really doubt it. I think this hand looks much nicer than it is in the spot. Listen to you by playing. Caught my ear! I'm amazed you can do that. Well, actually, yeah, I played a little on the side as well when I was modding it up in the Jane Anders channel. And we certainly would have flopped relatively interesting. Well, not that much, actually. But again, that never matters. So not a confirmed splash to pot maniac, we didn't see. But yeah, you know, it's not unusual to see the queen 9, 7-3 single suited or completely offsuit in these spots, like people going all in with them. Not a rare occasion by any means. What are we gonna do over here? Queen 7-6-4, I think it's fine with the big blind discount. Top pair, open ender. also an interesting spot down here. We do have the 9 as sort of a blocker. Oh. Okay. Don't get there down here. See what happens here. How did he take it down? Oh, with the Jack High Flush, right? The Jack 7, I think I saw flashing. Yeah. Jack High straight. And I think that went alright. In the sense that I lost the minimum there. Take it all in that he didn't take a stab there at any point with the blockers and in the end with the straight. In position, certainly worth knowing. I don't think so. With so many people left to act behind me. So let's take stock of the tables, why don't we? I think table 3 might be a candidate to switch out. Very tight, tight aggressive, very tight, sitting out, very tight. Of course me, very tight. Yeah. Check out the other tables. Table 1 seems alright. Table 2, lose passive, lose aggressive, sounds good to me. And table 4, of course, we have position and Kipperi, so let's dunk off a few buy-ins in his direction. Let's go for a lead here, might be fun. We have a gutter and some backdoor stuff. Short. You know, if he was full stacked, I would call. Since he's short, I don't really see the value in it. Don't flop that 7 all that often, or the flush draw allowing me to continue, and if I do, then I need him to be a deeper, I think. I think that's a good way of looking at it. Against this dude, I'm just gonna raise. Kind of unfortunate to be out of position against him. Flop top and bottom, just a thing that happened. Oh, the Kipperi table, Uncle Schnitzel. Hi, Uncle Schnitzel. Gonna let it go. Yeah, in case you're wondering, Uncle Schnitzel, why there's so many people watching me tonight, there was another Jay Nandis raid who brought 500 friends with him. And nothing embarrassing happened at all. I didn't have my mic muted when they came over. Nothing like that happened. And, you know, a whole bunch of people decided to stick around, watch me do some stuff at Pilo 20. Which is a nice thing indeed. The deuce and the 3, I'm gonna let it go. Even in position, there's better hands to call with there. Jack Jack 9-8, triple suited, sounds good enough on the button. Yeah, and we're up a whole bunch for today. So top pair, gutter, all the blockers in the world. Yeah, even having lost that huge pot which would have put us much further over the top. We are, hang on, we're three-way here. It's still okay. You're blocking 9-7. And with, yeah, having lost that big pot, we're still up 6 buy-ins for the day. That 3 is not the happiest of cards. Oh no, he's saying. Did he fold the 5-6? Kinda doubt it. Closing the action. I mean, he does have a lot of ace-x in his range, right, as the small blind. So I'm not really sure if he checks bluffing is the way to go here, and raising certainly doesn't seem to be the way to go. I have to give it up. King 5-2 is double suited on the button and a splash pot where there are 3 extra big blinds in there. Oof. Let's see about it once and then gonna let go. It doesn't need to work all that often. And it works often enough, I think. Get a call, with that we are done. End up making a very irrelevant pair. Could have like the queen jack, I guess. Nope. Snap call. This is straight, very interesting. Expensive information, but I'm gonna value bet the heck out of him now. Better. I'm gonna see bet here pretty much always. Just at the tail end of the hand, I noticed that I actually had the top pair. Like, duh, of course I'm gonna 3-bet. Didn't notice that for a second there. Oh well. And you know what, we are actually, by my count, overdue for a huge splash, so maybe that's gonna be a thing that happens. Only had 2 large ones at PLO 20 so far, seen a 200 big blind one, which I've never seen before during the promotion, when PLO 20 was introduced. They had like a 7 hours of, instead of 51% drag back, they gave back 80% in the form of splashes. And at the very tail end of that promotion, we saw a 1,000 big blind splash, which we almost won. We flopped. We had like a crap hand with a pair of threes. We flopped a set, but somebody else flopped a straight and ended up winning. You're not Greg? How dare you not being Greg? Okay. I thought you were in the hand there. Took it down here with the kings. Oh, okay. I'm opposite of you. Oh, you! Well, that is fair then. In that case, no one has position on the other. More than, you know, the other. Ooh! How nice is that for a flop? Jesus. I'm like completely locked up here. Not sure if it should be a check. raises. I'm gonna let it go. Get called here, which is a very happy thing indeed. Turn a flush draw on top, so now we really crush this board. Right, over here I raised a 3-bet call, I called, flopped the top pair, a gutter. And of course that flush draw. Let's watch what happens here first. Took it down on table 2, I think I had that in focus. Up making a flush. Seeing that the board is paired now, it might get checked through. I could have kings, king 10, there's no law against it. Needle. Check out what he 3-bet with there. Is this possibly? I don't know. No idea. No, yet. What did he have? With the 3, I'm gonna let it go. Who was it? Darren. Darren. At the good old 8655. Really? Not even double suited? Single suited and hearts? 2d8? Interesting. A red or lose 3-better, it seems. Let's come over top here with the double paired queens. Single suited to the queen as well. Really not looking for a 3-4-bet. Okay. Gonna call here. Very fine hand. That 9 is interesting. I could turn that to a bluff at this point. With all the queens, I think I will. I mean, I don't know how observant he is. He saw me bluff against Greg on this table earlier, possibly. Oof, okay. I'm gonna call here once. Yeah, I flop very well, I would say. The top set, and I think I'm just gonna pot it here. I blocked the nuts. Maybe I can get him out of it. Take it down on table 1, by the way. Doesn't make any difference if I bet or if I check here. He's never fold. Well, actually, sometimes he might find a fold. Oh, I'm just noticing his spades. Spades, really. As about folding 10 to 1. Yeah. And that turn bet was quite alright, I think.
I hope I had the right table in focus. I might not have this time. That'll work for me. Giving us the top set, the nuts right now. We have a gutter, two straight, and of course the second nut flush draw on top. A beautiful turn. Might be able to get that buy-in back. As far as rivers go, this one isn't so hot. Not blocking the straight. Maybe it's partner, I'm gonna have to let it go. Very, very unfortunate. Okay. At least we don't need to worry about being behind as far as the flush is concerned. So I mean, here over on table 3 when he called there for the pot size bet, I'm not sure if he was getting the right price, I can't do the math right now. So he blocked the straight himself by having the queen, he had a gutter to the nuts, and he had a third nut flush draw. I don't think I would be too happy calling that, and I don't think I would call it. To be honest, I would prefer my flush draw to be higher, I think. So certainly on the looser end, give him a green shirt for that. Ace, ace, nine, deuce here. Seems to be a good start. Screen 5-7, sleepy dude. It's fine as a raise fold, can also be just a call. Let's check that out in a moment. Wait until the preflop is over though. So I do have all the blockers to the straights. I've double gutter myself. Yeah, it's exactly that, it's a raised fold. I do have to double gutter. Top pair will do it. What's he thinking about now? He's slow rolling us with eights here. Shazam! So he did it with a marginal overpair. Well, why do you roll it up? I mean, not like that's the greatest spot to check raise. Just raise, not check raise. YOLO, YOLO indeed, my friend. Let's see if he is in YOLO mood. Right, so he had the king high flush. He blocked the deuce for whatever that's worth. And he had two jacks in there as well. Note taken. Not sure if he deserves a shirt for that spot, but it certainly was kind of interesting of him to do that. I don't think I would do that, which is... shouldn't mean anything about the quality of his play there, because, you know, I just might not know any better. Speaking of not knowing any better, I think single suited, that's a fault. You have some stuff on other tables. And here we have the queen I flush draw. Not draw, we have that queen I flush. Get raised here, which is no disaster with this hand. So pair, not flush draw, looks good to me. This dude isn't deep. Yeah, I'm gonna check fold. I think this could be a check call. Also a good point. I think I do a little bit too much c-betting. Yeah, I'm just gonna check now. And here things get interesting. So he came out of top pre, he raised. My raise, I called, get this flop. He didn't bet twice. Here I'm just gonna check it down. Lose it pretty much always. Yep. You know, I have middle set, a gutter. Be really surprised if he comes over the top now. That is a decent, decent river. Oh, Resto, yeah! I like it. I think I'm doing a little bit too much c-betting, and it's certainly something I really need to work on. It's one of the things that I always note when I watch Jane Anders play, that he is much more conservative with that, and which has very often the advantage that you're not building a huge pot where you're then forced to call with marginal hands and marginal spots because of just the pot odds. Yeah, that certainly turned out to be a YOLO spot there. It's still an interesting situation, I feel, the way he played it. So Ralph had enough. Ralph raises, which is a tongue twister in its own right. Okay, not getting lucky this time. But in a splash pot, some extra money in there. I don't think it's horrible. Here, I'm just gonna straight up fold it against Kipperi. It's unfortunate. He bets really small. Interesting. Yeah, check call. I hadn't thought about it at all. To just go the check call way there. I like it. And right now, for... the PLO 10 player is possibly out there. 7 entries at PLO 10. So somebody got in there. We had the aces, well done. And he won a nice pot. What did the other dude have? Let's check this out. 8-7-6-5. Wow, Kipperi had to fade like half the deck there. Nice hand, Kipperi. With the aces. We hit the 4-5 and you had a complete wrap. He had a pair and a complete wrap with a 6-7-8 there. Certainly not a happy spot when you see that hand turned over with your against your aces. With two cards to come. Let's watch. I fold anything that I shouldn't have? Nope. So in the last minutes, won a little, lost a little, still up. Unchanged, 6 minds up for the day. Certainly nice. But the ace doesn't really change anything here. A set against what did Kipri show up with? Two pair, king 3-8-6, double suited, so on the turn, 8 high flush draw as well. Fair enough. Actually, this was a little bit too quick to check there. This could have been a nice spot to bet now on the turn. After he checked really quickly on the flop. Here, I opted to check. What does my note say on this guy? Called with the straight on the 4-flush river. Oh, that was the call happy dude there. I remember. So definitely, I'm gonna check here again. Keep the pot small. All happy dude, huh? He checked in position though, so maybe he doesn't need to have a queen here. Checks now, I see no reason to bluff him. Kings. King, king, 3-4. Interesting. So, in a hand with Kipri, where we have third nut flush draw, over pair, a little bit of a blocker with the 5. Turning an open-ender. We have a queen of clubs as well, which is helpful. I was gonna say, I wouldn't be surprised if Kipri calls. It's a 6-4, 2 pair. Nice hand, he says. With a bottom or low 2 pair there. I have to give you a green shirt, Kipri, in one of these days. Give you the note call happy. But you know, I can't really point fingers. You took down the pot, that is all that matters. I mean, just letting it go is an option as well. Limping in the splash, certainly an option as well. Very marginal. And he raises and I'm gonna let it go. Fair enough. I think it was way too thin to open. Wait, actually, let's check it out. There was the button. I think it might not be, maybe I'm talking nonsense. Yeah, perfect. Raise fold. Way to go. I was talking nonsense. Wasn't doing nonsense. Was talking nonsense, though. Calling here seems alright. Interesting flop. Pair, second, no, third nut flush draw. Case in point. And it got her to the nuts. And that's the full pot. He was the one who 3-bet 8-6-5-5, single suited. 3 ways. Okay. Yeah, I think betting this right out, I don't mind. If I get raised, I can easily give it up now. And I prefer the 2 just calling. Also not sure about this one. With the 6 in there, I don't think it's completely horrible either way. Did get the big blind discount. Quad queens? Not that I remember. Kipri, not that I remember. What was it? Queen, queen, 10-6. Big blind versus under the gun. Suited. No, it's fine. It is perfectly alright. So it seems so far the 6 people that have voted on the poll underneath the channel, if you scroll down, are all in favor of having a one table view as often as possible. So there's certainly an indicator that I want to do this from now on. Under the gun, I'm gonna let it go. It's a 5 in there. I will check it out though, never hurts. I'm certain it has to be a fold under the gun. Against Kippery here. We could have a lot of stuff in the big blind. But it's also very call happy. So let's see how this goes. We'll go our way, I think, with this turn. Yeah, the king hand, king 10-10-5 is certainly a fold. Not surprising, just gonna check behind here. Be surprised to be behind, but nope. King 10. Kippery pukes. Check some money is in here. Certainly a spot that makes me go Have a gutter, backdoor flush. I could play decent stuff pretty passively. Just gonna give up on this. And you know, even if the nodes here are only for that one table, they're certainly helpful to have. Top pair blockers. With the queen, I think I can find a reason to see bet. If I get raised, it's not like I lose massive amounts of equity. Just give it up. As for one table zooming, yeah, okay, I'll, you know, coming from you, that does mean a lot. Thanks for telling me, Kippery. And this table has lost all its appeal, has lost the Kippery factor, and, you know, it's three-handed, so I'm gonna ditch it. Open another one, plenty of tables to choose from, 50 entries at PLO 20 right now. Yeah, so that's what I'll do from now on, Kippery, then. Doesn't seem like anybody is voting for the opposite. And I guess for all the people watching on mobile, it is quite a relief. Call it beyond a turn. It's 6. Both fairly deep, let's do it. Not an easy board. Especially not against a call happy dude. He checks. Let's keep this one small in position. I think that is fine. Why was I so stupid to deposit only 150 in the beginning? Yes! You know, not that that's a happy thing to hear, but... for anybody watching, if you're thinking about joining Run at Once, consider depositing as much as you can to get the most of the deposit bonus, which is unique, and it's the same as all the other deposit bonuses. What makes it unique is the fact that you can take forever to unlock it, which is the only reason why I'm mentioning I'm not much of a marketing dude. Yeah, play one hand a month and you can take years and years to unlock that bonus, so which is, that's what Kipri is talking about there. And LB only deposited 50. Ugh. Yeah, and that's the other thing, you can withdraw the money and the bonus remains there. So you don't need to, you know, take advantage of the whole 600 and then have the 600 laying there for years. You can just deposit it, play a little. I'm sure you have to play some hands before you can withdraw it. And then yeah, enjoy the bonus. And I bonus hoard a lot in the last 16 months. Up and down my way through the microgaming network. I think I'm very... I have accounts on almost all the sites. Bar like one or two. Some Splashpot Madness here, possibly. I can use screenshots and streams. Because Kipperi is using a, you know, a green screen behind him. And then, of course... he would be a floating hat. Gotta go do some work for a while. Yeah, that has to come first. Thanks for, you know, being part of the stream for so long. Gonna let this go. Suited to the queen is not a happy thing if we do flop the flush draw. All kinds of trouble down the road. Yeah, case in point, we would have had the gutter. We couldn't... And flush draw would be tough to fold here. Especially now if he should call. Interesting spot here. Flop the open and the straight flush draw. And of course, you know, the overpair. And to boot, the second nut flush draw. He's the passive dude still, I think. Yeah. Let's bet this. Needle. And it looks like that's shaping up to be another three-handed table. Actually, that's true for table 4 and table 3, so let's move some new ones in then. Let's go. A little bit too thin to raise, but I would like to be part of this hand. Interesting board. Times 2 over here as well, where I had to call because it was a nice splash and the raise wasn't that large, like 60 cents.
And here, I think I'm gonna call it once.
Der Alte, quite a crowd, yeah, you know it. And I'm running reasonably well.
Don't think I'm doing too many stupid things either. Yeah, I had to fold against a sizable re-raise there, not having a single spade in my hand.
And yet, another Jane Anders raid happened.
Tight passive, huh? I think this is sort of a judgment call here. What the move is. I'm gonna earn the tighter side of things. Here I came over the top, pre. With the 9 in my hand, I wanna bet this quite large, I think. 9 is a blocker, I mean.
Yeah, I'm running well. Welcome back to the channel, Der Alte, as well.
Take it down, that's certainly nice. And I should be up. Let's check it out. Should still be up around 6 buy-ins, I think. Do I want to be part of this on the button? Ace-7-5-4, maybe?
Up 5 buy-ins right now.
Really? I do have that wrap. It's very passive. Let's call once, see what happens. Interesting, so noted. He likes the pot-sized bets, huh?
Very nice hand here.
One gapped rundown. Okay. I think I'm gonna try it. Do we have a note on this dude? Nope. Oof, lot of my mind. And I do have the Ace of Spades, huh?
Actually, I should have bet smaller to get the most of out of my nut flush blocker. Because once the SPR gets really low, you know, it's tough for people to fold a mediocre flush.
And this is not the board I was looking for, re-raising with aces here. Is a little bit snug, and he goes for the immediate pot size bet, huh? Right away. Well, fair enough then. Got a pair, backdoor. Two pair. Make that a nut straight. Neato. Sure. No, table one is breaking. Everybody just left it. Right, so I think with the gap, two of the button, triple suited, I'm gonna let this one go. Let's check it out. No? Wait, I checked the wrong thing. Yep, it's perfect. With c8, it's a race call. It's a 7, it shouldn't be. Right. Let's give him the business. Oof. He was the passive dude too. Show what the move is. I think not giving a free card is not a bad idea. And to my relief, took it down. But still, for this hour, 37 entries, PLO 50, 6 entries, PLO 10, and the same PLO 50, which is unusually quiet. PLO 50 usually has PLO 20 beat during the day, during weekdays, and is doing quite well in the evenings. But as I said, it seems to be peculiar about random ones right now, that the weekend nights seem to be a little bit quieter, quieter than the week nights. No Limit Hold'em is doing well though. 27 entries, No Limit 4, 24, No Limit 20, 13, No Limit 100, 6, and 5 respectively for No Limit 2 and 500. Nice, some games, and some big games going down as well. Would have made the Alter Rich again. Oh, with the raffle, the jackpot you could go on. Right, right. Royal Flush and Quartz in the short session. Jesus. Now, he was call happy, so I don't really mind calling for well, still a reasonable price with the splash. But no more money is going in on the sport. Down here. Oh no, crap. Unadulterated crap here. Can't even justify a limp. You know I will, but can't justify it. Yeah, sure. Win with crap. Hey, epic. Yeah, the Jane Endes raid happened. Thanks a lot. And you know, a whole bunch of the Genetis viewers decided to stick around. Okay, so there's stuff going on all over the place. Big pot happening here without me. I'm gonna switch back to the other table as soon as action develops there. Okay, took it down with re-raise. Let's check what's happening here. A setback, huh? So,
I raised, he raised, and since the other dude called, I figured I'm getting a decent price to be in here, and I'm gonna call once, and if the board doesn't pair, well, no, I'm not gonna go all in. He has the aces here quite a lot. I blocked the kings, queens. Hope for a reasonable bet size here. I'm afraid he's gonna put it in. Yeah, I have to go with it. Yeah, he has aces and we don't get there. But I think Devon played it. Did I have the right table in focus there? I might not have. If so, then I'm sorry. Right. If you can see, there was a ace-10-6 board. I had king-queen-jack-10. So a pair and, you know, the wrap. And yeah, I had to call the turn all in there. Couldn't really do anything else, I felt. Ace king-9-3. Not sure. Either way, it's not horrible. That is certainly not horrible. And Chancepeda in the house as well. Things are going well, Chance. Up, having lost this one, up 4 binds for the day. Certainly not bad. Head game is on point. Just gonna give it up. I guess a different line, just check calling is a way to go, or check raising might be a fun thing. Talking about fun things, this might help on our quest to get that buy-in back that we just lost there. Yeah, I got my swag! Let's do this. What you got? A low rundown. Okay, certainly not nice, but we take it down. This time I did have the right table. He never bet. Let's try to get a small one out of him. Wait here, sorry. He did admit, ended up making that straight. Kind of funny. So here I came over the top. This is, what does my note say? Only calls. He called. Only called to flop trips in an earlier hand. I remember that hand. So as the 3-better, I'm not never checking on this board. The poker streets just got a little better with the hand I won there. And up 5 buy-ins thereabouts. So all in all, quite nice. As played, I'm not getting him off a king. Am I though? Nah, I think I thought too long. To sell a bluff here. So what in the world? He did have jacks, yeah. Ace 10, jack, jack. Okay. With hearts. Fair enough. A little bit stumped. Yeah, let's check the tally here. Just a hair under 5 buy-ins. This might help, although those are not great aces as far as aces go. But maybe we get lucky and somebody comes over the top. Certainly be nice to be able to put another bet in. Especially if somebody comes over top now. Come on, Julian. Kings are good. I promise ya. Turns out kings would be good. Just gonna let it go. I do have the aces as blocker to the Broadway, but meh. So he checks, he should have the most kings of all of us. And I think there's a reasonable chance we're good, unless there's a 10, scared 10-9 out there. Like, if he bets now, I'm gonna be really... I guess 10-9 is the only thing that makes sense. Or, you know, river 4s, but I have 4. I'm gonna call him here. Really? White checked the turn. What? So not only did he have the full house, he had he flopped a set with queens, which I understand the turn check behind, but still, I had a flop check behind. But how weird was that? Hate to mention it, but aces immediately, you know. There is a chance of Peter factor when it comes to the whole cards I'm getting. It is becoming more and more apparent that that's a thing. Big splash up here. It's like €2, so 10 big blinds. Over here I raised and I intend to check it down if I can. Let's watch this stall. Take it down. Defended here, the big blind here against the button. It's certainly a nice card. Do I need to turn this into a bluff? Sure. Still lose to, you know, tens. Kings for sure. That is. I would have bet a lot of rivers, not necessarily this one. Let's go for it. Is that I'm coming over the top tank, or is it I'm considering a fold tank? It's considering a fold tank, but I'm not folding. With the 8 high flush, so value, and a queen as well. Did you have a full house there? Wow, she just called on the turn, huh? With trips. People are playing very tight, it seems. Very passive. Ooh. Certainly looks nice. Then let's watch here. What is it? A 3 big blind splash? I had not enough to call, that is for sure. Triple suited, I think I'll let this one go. Versus the MP range here, or under the gun, depending on your perspective. Not sure if this is too frisky. It might be one pip too low with the 5. Let's check it out once the preflop is over. certainly an interesting board. Yeah, it's close. Even, well, it's not perfectly double-suited, that part I hadn't quite noticed. But even perfectly double-suited, the 9-5, 9-6 would be the cutoff for a raise, and double-suited like they are, it's the 9-7. So it's not a huge deal, but still. The top pair, the flush draw, him checking, I think I'm gonna pot it here. Not blocking straight draws that much. It's not a great card. We do have that. I mean, I do have that 5. Screw you. It's ace-5-3. If I hadn't had the 5 in my hand, I would have just folded there. But that was kind of the deciding factor for me. Not really too mad about it. But I do feel a certain fatigue setting in. So I think ending the stream in the next 20 minutes is the way to go. I found someone very fun to host, a high stakes no limit player, apparently. And he was the one that somebody asked Jen Anders to host when he decided to bring all of you over here. And why not pay it forward and host this guy then? So yeah, another 15-20 minutes of stream. I think that's gonna be fine, unless I catch a second wind. Never know. I did eat a lot of onions today, I might. Not looking to get 3-bet with this hand. This is a very nice flop. And I think I'm gonna pot it here. If he wants to get it in, then we'll get it in. Certainly a fine hand to open on the button with. Side cards decently connected, suited to the ace. All kinds of alright. And, you know, ditto. Also fine enough for a raise. Well, the 9s are very effective blockers, that's about it right now. Blind versus blind, sure. Otherwise, I would have folded this. Okay, it's a nice turn. Yeah, I do block king queen quite heavily, so might not needn't have a king here. See what he does.
He was 2-2-2, only called the flop trips. Not tonight. And what's the move here? Two block top set. Back to a flush draw, let's see. I don't really see too many worse hands calling here. King queen, king ten, sure they might. Check out what these peeps had. Ooh, I like it. See, we had a king 6-4 deuce in there, and we had a 10-9-7-6. Play this a little bit different for a change. Not bad, not parted. Been down to 3 better. But why not mix it up every once in a while? I think we're good. Like, if he bets now, I'm definitely gonna call. He call with there, like in. Couldn't have an ace queen, I guess, like sort of a rundown. Ace 10, jack 9, okay. Single suited and spades to the ace. Doing quite a lot of raising on this table. Curious, nobody decided to come over the top yet. There you go. What timing. I think I let it go out of position. With the deuce in there, yeah. And following up that ooh with another ooh. Ace, ace, check 8. Single suited and clubs to the ace. Can we get a raise, sir? Nope. I'll just check behind. Certainly doesn't make life easier. Good card. Sounds good to me. 10-7. No. Neato. Also neat. It's a very nice looking queen, queen, jack 10, double suited in a splash pot where he opts not to raise the max. And he is sitting deep, just noticing. To that one in a moment. So what's the backdoor flush draw? I'm gonna call it once. This might give him pause. Right, all in all, a pretty decent turn. We are blocking the nuts, having the straight. He bets and I'm gonna let it go. Turn was questionable, but he bet half pot with the backdoor flush. In position, not sure. What better move is there? And down a little in the last minutes. We're still up 3 buy-ins for the day. That's still quite alright. Let's check with the old 7 deuce. I can't imagine that being a fold on the button. I'll check it out in a moment. Never hurts. And you know, the ranges I have in my head are still very much focused on the legacy ranges from my short stacking days, I should, is a good way of putting it. It's perfectly fine. Just gonna let it go. Late position raiser, like every once in a while this might be fun to just pot it. Nah, not against an LP raise. Let's watch here. Big pot. Alrighty. Is wow. What in the deuce with ace queen queen three? Let's do the splash pot special here. See if you can get a limp through. Raising this under the gun seems a little bit too adventurous. A pair and a gutter. Ooh, let's watch this. It's a call here, by the way. If the aces have a raise in front of me, he not checks. Okay. And this dude has an open folding range on the button. Certainly noteworthy at PLO 20, I find. Mm.
Someone she checks behind. I think. Trying to take it down now isn't bad. And I think I would do this with like queens, kings as well, aces. And he feels the same way. Let this one go. Yeah. I think one or two more orbits and then I'll color the knight. And let's post that high stakes Nolan player who apparently just started streaming in this. I've been told that he's doing a great job. Yeah, and at this time I couldn't tell you what happened here, if I raised or no, I think I called a raise, and that's fine with that hand. Pot sized, never mind. Yeah, but case in point, I think it's time to end the stream in a few moments. Well, we are three-handed. Certainly a nice hand, nice board for it. Sized, huh? Let's take one off. Against the pot size. I'm having second thoughts. Not because, you know, I didn't get my flush, just generally speaking. I'm gonna fold there on table 3. Plop a gutter here, and that is it. He updated here, decided to come over the top. He bets on the other table for 3/4, so I'm gonna let it go. Tough board. Could certainly check it. Really? Dude, his pot size is getting on my nerves. Nah, not really. But it's certainly putting me into a tough spot there. Nah, I have to let it go. Ooh. Like 3 buy-ins. I might have lost a few big blinds here and there just now. Yeah, still, 3 buy-ins. Yep. And tables are breaking. It's not, you know, there's still 22 entries in the pool, so it's not like we couldn't get any new tables going. But I feel it's alright to call it quits now. So here I decided to check. Just let it go.
gonna call this with the ace-high flush draw and all that jazz. Actually, this is a board where I might have a tough time calling on. Without a 10. Nice. Right, so thank you everybody for coming around and for, you know, for so many of you for sticking around and watching me and instead of, you know, someone else. It's very much appreciated. I'll host it, No Limit Dude, in a moment. And should you like to stream, you know, then feel free to check back in. If you want, you can follow the channel, then you get... Sorry. Then you get notified by Twitch whenever I'm online. Otherwise, if that's not your thing, that's cool, then... just if you want, check back in my schedules in the, on the page, and I stream pretty much every day for 8 hours or more. Yeah. Finished up the session like around 3 binds in profit, and not to draw this out any longer. Appreciate you keeping me company. Maybe I'll see you around. Have a nice Sunday evening.